Welcome to Talk and Cheese Podcast. One DJ. Podcast. One comedian. Two other guys.
Talk and Cheese.
Come on.
You are an awesome
Begging.
Oh, God. I need a cigarette.
Anyway.
This one, your iPhone back.
He's stressed about his iPhone.
He's not stressed about his iPhone. It's a little tape.
So, Kane, what's this about Mel B and Eddie Murphy? What's going on with this?
Brother. She's getting $21,000 a month.
Good.
Why is it good?
Because Eddie's a pussy.
He's got 10 kids.
Why is he a pussy? Do you know him personally?
Because he beat the thing and he left her. A scorn woman is a terrible one.
Yo, what? No, don't do that. That's
terrible.
No, but what? All right. So let me just say what's happened now. So basically, he's giving her $21,000 a month for child support. That don't include medical expenses.
That's on camera.
Shush! It don't include medical expenses or education. So that 21 grand is just for lobster and scallops. Because what are you going to spend 21 grand on a month? And then to now, basically, she's not been making any money. She's not been making any money for the past year or so. So she's saying, she's taking him to court, saying she wants more money.
Rascal.
Yeah.
She's
gone back to her mum's.
She's that
brought
like that.
She's gone back. She's in Leeds.
She brought like that.
She's brought them like that.
But she's gone back to her mum's for real.
No, but broke. Is he broke?
She can't come live with me.
Broke in their world is not broke like us.
Yeah.
But she's got money, but
that happens to all of us. That happens to us. Every man who goes back to their mums, Mel B's in the same boat.
She's broke, isn't it?
No, but no.
I don't care. Oh, but I got money though.
Yeah, your mum's, you cunt.
You come back to your mum's.
Big Ross.
You understand? How is your brat different from my brat? You're at your mum's.
And she's in her 40s.
You understand?
And you've gone back to your mum's.
It can happen. It can happen.
Sleeping in, all right, listen,
I don't care if you're Mel B.
So you're saying if Mel B is sleeping on her mum's couch and, you know, at 7 o'clock, her mum comes in to watch. GMTV. Mel's got to get up and walk out. She's got peace. She's
there. I can
walk around my house naked and I can walk and doo-doo.
Like a horse.
Yeah, if I wanted to. She can't do that at her mum's house.
You can't, really. Poor dad.
Have you tried that?
I don't think he would like to see his naked dad shit.
But what? I'm just saying.
Come
but celebrities that are, hold on, wait. But celebrities that...
Fix your phone.
Celebrities that are... Celebrities that are broke, yeah? It's not broke as in they don't have a penny necessarily, but it's the lifestyle that I'm used to.
Yeah.
I can't continue that anymore.
Then you're broke then.
At this rate. Yeah, of course you're broke.
That's broke.
You're broke. But it don't mean that she might have a half a meal, three quarters of a meal something.
That's broke.
But she can't, yeah, in their
that's
world.
In their world, that's
but
broke.
She can't carry on with the lifestyle she's got. With the money she's got.
But she can't get a studio flat.
No, but it's like... No, all right, imagine this, yeah? No, but
it's her mum's couch. Her mum's couch has got like the plastic on it. Yeah. She's got old mum. So she's sweating at night.
Three months of Eddie Murphy money can get her back up again, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's not
it's
that.
Not, no, remember, they've got a high lifestyle.
Are ridiculous.
So where's Eddie Murphy making money from then?
It's Eddie.
I don't know.
Eddie can't, bro.
Eddie's got money.
Eddie's
got money. Spice Girls was big things.
She made 3 million.
Eddie retired a long time ago. Remember, Eddie has retired a long time ago. He's got peas.
He's got money.
He got money.
Remember, Spice.
Real money.
Remember, Spice duns, you know. When you have Spice in your cupboard, it done. You have to re-film the Spice.
Our Spice Girls must be getting royalties.
Where? When last have you heard something even on a fucking advert? You don't hear nothing.
They were in the advert with your virgin.
Who?
Gupta.
Gupta.
Oh, Gus.
Gus.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. That's how brought that. Right now, me and Chris will get them in the skit.
Yo, Emma.
Yeah, the whole of them as well, the whole Spice Girls.
No, apart from Victoria.
Yeah, Victoria.
She lined herself up with her.
So the rest of them, three bills, you get the whole Spice Girls.
Three bills.
Three bills for the Spice Girls. Can you imagine though? You see the Spice Girls, like, Spice Girls playing that one pub in Tottenham. You get the, really, is that Spice Girls going there? All of them.
That's why in life it's fucked to peak too early, you know? Because when I look at Essa Club 7, They were big.
Yeah,
they couldn't do no wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Like Britney's fighting for her money back now from her dad, isn't it?
Boy, there's a lot of people.
See, after she shaved her head, she went mad.
Yeah.
The dad took.
Fame and money ain't always. They don't always equate.
No.
Do you get what I'm saying? So getting two number ones and being the most famous person.
Yeah, they're right.
Don't mean that, but it just means you can't work.
If you got
two number ones. Fuck!
If you were famous like that, do you think you'd go broke? If you were famous like that,
Dizzlewood.
Yeah, but famous.
Honestly, no disrespect.
No, that's just no. Wow.
He's saying if Dizzle got rich.
No, he said famous.
Yeah, but and rich.
No, and rich.
You would have gone broke if Maybe now, you know why? Maybe now it might be different, but he'd go broke.
Yeah, because wow. he's a styler. You're one of them that like, no, I can't wear that because they see me in that already.
This all spending money, you know, before he's
I can't. I have to get them.
My outfits, one
not, use. No, not 20,000 plate. I need 21 now. That's you, blood.
And it wasn't
you know me, I will stick to 2,000. I'll stick to plate 2,000.
I don't think this will go broke.
Thank you.
But you know what? Let me tell you, would you like to know why?
Go on then.
He'll go broke and then he'll try hustle. He'll try hustle everybody. Yo, Steven Spielberg. You'll be like, yo, Spielberg.
I don't think he'll go broke. I think he'll flood the road with a couple boxes, though. He's always got peace coming in.
You're doing
beer boxes. Yeah. Beer boxes. Nah. New thing. You know, like black magic, but it'd just be like this.
Yeah. Blue magic. Blue magic. See, I'm glad to know how you're thinking.
No, you've got this. Is funny. I agree with you.
You've got a high chest.
Fully go broke.
You're bougie.
You go broke, and it's not because. Look, listen.
I would town down my.
No, you wouldn't. earning money. All right, earning money, and keeping it. Two completely different skills. Mm. See, once you earn money, that's the one part of it. You know
the hardest part maintaining
the
it.
The hard part
to earn money though.
To see if.
That's what I said. The earning part ain't necessarily the hardest part. The hardest part is doing the right thing with the money.
I do the right thing with the money. Told you that came.
You're a styler. You're a styler.
You are, bro.
You're a styler.
You are definitely a styler, but I definitely think that.
I don't think you're that stupid. Yeah, obviously. No, I don't think you're that stupid, man. But I think you will go broke. Like, but slowly, but you will. And then you still try to style on everybody.
I feel like if you all got famous doing your thing,
you're gonna start contacting people, hey, you know who I am. Let me wear your clothes for you.
If you all got famous and rich, but then your career done. Yeah?
Yeah.
I think you'd go broke first. Gucci. But I think you'd eventually go broke.
I would.
You probably invested.
I'd invest my money straight.
Yeah.
Listen, I wouldn't invest my money on the roads. Are you fucking mad?
It's COVID, though. It's a bit mad.
A couple of trap houses.
Idiot.
You wouldn't invest.
So what would I do?
Because what you would do?
So I'd just be living like a brat pocket.
No, you wouldn't. No, this is what you do.
That's what you're saying.
I'll tell you what you do. I would kill myself.
I don't know about that.
You wouldn't invest in like long term.
You're mad, bro. You're telling me I'll go broke. So basically, you're telling me I would live on the road like a brat pocket.
No.
And you would be rich. Fuck you, lot.
Is that what I said?
No.
Fuck you, lot.
This is what
you're saying. I'd have all my money, then I'd be on the road, bro.
No one said that.
And that's where people.
He'll be calling out Gucci. Yo, Gucci, you remember
me? Gucci. Sergio Tashini. McGrath. Theodora. Hello.
Pony.
Excuse me, Kappa. Are you still in business?
Kappa, you said. Yeah. Can you imagine?
Have you got the oil lily jacket?
This is good.
I'm looking for any brand. Gabici opens still. The one up here on Farrah's.
Endorsement. We said the real life branches.
You know what it is? You know what it is though? Because you like things quickly, fast things. So you get 100 grand and you'll be like, I'll get that tomorrow. I've got this job coming up, and you keep doing that. And then one day, you're not the thing anymore.
All the money's gone.
Yeah, and then you realise you only got about 2 grand left. You know what I'm saying? Because all this 100 grand dry up. Because you always think you're going to get it. That's what it is. Because I'm this, innit? I'll get 100 grand tomorrow, and then one day you realise, well, no one ain't calling me.
This is going to phone back the selectors. You see the money pull up again? Run back some money.
Yeah, you start turning hustler.
Whatever, I've got good people around me now. I'm good with money.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You need good people like around you, like Floyd Mayweather. He's shit with money. He's a gambler, but he needs people like Al Heyman.
He can make money.
Yeah,
but he spends.
But he needs people like Al Heyman and all of them man there around him to sort him out. Yeah,
you can earn, but you're a spender as well.
100%.
Okay, so let's get back to the topic. Let's get back to the topic. So Mel B.
You saw the you can.
Mel B. So what's happened? She just wants the piece.
So she wants more money. She's taking him to court.
But has he ever been a dad to the daughter?
That's irrelevant.
It's not irrelevant.
She's irrelevant. But she's got sole custody.
21 fucking grand a month.
You're not supposed
to want nothing.
Yeah, listen, I don't want to see if you've never.
Why would I want to see
the baby? I don't just get married. I don't need to see
it. If you've never been a dad, if you've never been a dad to your daughter, remember, you know, it's about lifestyle. Look at fucking Dr. Dre's woman. She wanted how much million. It's all about the lifestyle that they live.
What's 21 times 12? How much is she getting per year?
$250,000.
That's not too bad, you know. Quarter mil for
skin out of pussy.
Hey, listen, Khalees was getting what, 50 grand a month from Nas? I don't know how, and he's not even got any money. But he ain't got any money.
He's got money.
No, now he has, but back then.
Nas is an investor, you know.
Yeah, now Nas is proper rich now. But I'm saying back then, yeah, back then when Khalees was getting it, he wasn't doing nothing with his life, and then she was getting 50 bags a month off of him, blood. And I'm like, whose lawyer is fucked up dogs like
that? It's their lifestyle that they live, bro. He might not have had things, but he was doing what you're saying Dizzle would do.